and sit and I see the fighting, artillery, the bombs playing with Japanese aeroplanes. It is madness. I met two officers at the recruitment center. They took a liking for me. I was drafted to go to the war in India and Burma. The fighting was so ferocious. I've never seen any troops that fight like Japanese. When you see an enemy and you hesitate, he will kill you straight away. So we were not sluggish. We were there for a purpose, to kill or to be killed. And some of the river up to our neck like this. A bullet touches your brother, and he fell. You just look. You have no right to go back, touch him, or do anything. You keep moving. When you weep, you'll be court-martialed. You go and hide yourself. When things are cool down small, you weep quietly. You wipe your face. Nobody sees it. We are black. Japanese snipers, they don't see the black color. Every morning, at the end of the day, you see that six or seven whites will die, but no black. So they brought camouflage ointment, black, like the ointment, to cover their face, the killing storm. So sometimes we used to laugh at them. You see, God has helped us. We are black, and they don't see us. You see? Soldiers are more than brothers. Comradeship, the relationship is excellent. Both whites and blacks.
Their fathers fought with spears. But these men handle their modern weapons as expertly as crack white gunners.
If you come outside to civil life, then we play all our color prejudice and tribalism and all that. There, no. Past memories flood back to you. I sit and I see the fighting, artillery, the bombs playing Japanese aeroplanes. It is madness. War is never good. I have experienced it. I'm 95. I have experienced. I have seen. I have passed through it. What we did, we laid down our life for humanity, to save others, to enjoy their peace.